Zooper Heroes! A team of friends and animals working together! Splash the penguin! Patience the sloth! The pollinator a bee! Karma chameleon! Frog the croaker! With Robin!
Wow, it was so good to see all my friends on Zoom today. I really missed Robin and the other Zooper Heroes. But you know what I noticed? I noticed that the croaker was talking about hopping, and Splash was talking about having a pool, because they're a good swimmer. They have wings, but they don't even use them to fly. I guess we just have all different ways of moving our bodies. Do all animals move different ways? I wonder. Maybe we can find out today together. What do you think?
Animal of the day.
It's movement day. How do frogs move? Oh, that guy's blinking and turning. Interesting. Climbing, look at those sticky toe pads. He can go straight up. Oh, now she's tucking, and I can see her breathing. Climbing some more. Oh, sometimes they hide in camouflage like a leaf. Sometimes they just get away. Frogs can move in all different ways. I bet these white tree frogs could use those long legs to hop too if they wanted.
I spy.
Can your eyes spot the rabbits in these next two pictures? The first one is a bit easier, but feel free to pause the video to take a longer peek. For this trickier picture, try to use the rabbit's shapes or body parts, like their ears, to find the rabbit. Now, you can check your guesses. Did you spot both of the rabbits?
A scientist uses a microscope to look at things up close. Can you guess what I'm looking at under my microscope? This is a critter I found in my backyard. I found it hiding under a log. Can you guess what this slimy critter is? It's a slug.
Tick tock.
Hi friends, welcome back. This song is all about animals and how they move. For this song, we are going to sing to the tune of Mary Had a Little Lamb. Do you guys know that one? Let's see if you remember. Mary had a little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb whose fleece was white as snow. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take that song and insert different animals and how they move. All right, friends, are you guys ready to learn the animal movement song? So I moved outside because for this song, we're going to need some area to dance in. I hope you guys are good dancers. So the very first verse is kangaroos go hop, hop, hop. Kangaroos go hop, hop, hop. Hop, 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 hop. Kangaroos go hop, hop, hop. And then at the very end we say, that is how they move. So at the very end of every verse we always sing, that is how they move. All right, let's put the dance moves to it. Ready? Kangaroos go hop, 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 hop. Kangaroos go hop, hop, hop. That is how they move.
All right, ready for the next one?
Butterflies go flap, 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 flap. Butterflies go flap, flap, flap. That is how they move.
You guys are doing such a good job.
Elephants go stomp, 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 stomp. Elephants go stomp, stomp, stomp. That is how they move. Fish go oh, swim, 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 swim. Fish go oh, swim, swim, swim. That is how they move. Penguins go oh, waddle, 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 waddle. Penguins go oh, waddle, waddle, waddle. That is how they move. Rattlesnakes go slither, 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 slither. Rattlesnakes go slither, slither, slither. That is how they move. Spiders go ooh, scurry, 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 scurry. Spiders go ooh, scurry, scurry, scurry. That is how they move. Sloths go ooh, very slow, very slow, very slow. Sloths go ooh, very slow. That is how they move.
Wow! You guys did an awesome job!
Welcome to the Unknown Caller. Have you ever heard this animal sound? Whose call is it? Yell it out if you have a guess. It's crickets! Today is Animal Movement Day, so we're looking at crickets and grasshoppers who make sounds by moving parts of their body. Crickets rub the one edge of their wing against the other to make a sound. Grasshoppers rub their leg against their wing to make a sound. Aren't insects awesome? I hope you get to go out and hear some today, or maybe even tonight.
Snail mail!
Dear Robin, Missoul is an island located in West Papua, Indonesia. We are here for a scuba diving expedition, and today we watched manta rays congregate at an underwater cleaning station. They glide in and hover over the reef, and the fish sweep up and clean all the parasites off their skin and from inside their gills. It was fascinating to watch, especially since the manta rays are so huge, 12 to 18 feet across. Thankfully, there are plenty of fish to help. Love, Aunt Stephanie.
Yoga.
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 Now it's your turn to move. We're going to do a yoga pose that looks like a frog. So find a spot where you can stand up and move around a little bit. Spread your feet pretty wide apart and make sure your toes are pointing out a little bit instead of facing in front of you. Then you're going to squat down and put your hands on the ground in front of you like a frog. If you want, you can sway a little bit from side to side by picking up one heel at a time. Then you can test your balance by picking up your hands and placing them together in front of your chest. When you're done with the pose, just put your hands back on the ground and straighten your legs, and then you can slowly stand up again. Great job!
Ask an expert.
What do you know about sharks?
Sharks eat fish.
Sharks eat fish? That's a good fact.
There are no waters in the sea, so I learned that sharks eat to sit in the sea.
Out and about.
Let's try and find some Missouri animals and see how they move. Who do you think we can find in a log pile? It's a Midland brown snake. I wonder how it moves. How do you think snakes slither?
Scales underneath and stay soft, sort of in like the soft ground when they settle usually.
That's right. Snakes slither using the scales on their bellies, called scutes. Another way snakes move is by swimming. All snakes can swim. Pretty cool, huh?
Animal actions.
Do you recognize this animal? It's a black-tailed prairie dog. You may have seen them at the zoo. They live out in the western part of the United States. These guys love to eat all kinds of grasses and seeds. Let's pretend to be a prairie dog. Get down on the ground. Prairie dogs live in big groups called towns, and they have burrows all over with different rooms. When prairie dogs are out and about, they need to look for food, which is going to be grasses or seeds, and sometimes insects. Animals who look for food like this are called foragers. You can see our prairie dog friend right now, using his nose to sniff around for food. Let's try and be a prairie dog again. This time we'll go real slow. Look closely on the ground for yummy things to eat. Do you see an insect crawling over there? Oh, wait, listen carefully. There might be a predator. Prairie dogs are very small, so they have many kinds of animals that can eat them. They even have words for different animals in their barks. Coyotes, snakes. But what could be up in the sky that they would worry about? Can you think of an animal that flies that might want to eat a prairie dog? Some prairie dog's job is to stand guard. They're called a sentry. If everything's safe, they can snack for a bit, but they're always listening. If you hear anything, make sure you look really, oh, there's something again. I wonder if it was the flapping of a hawk wing. The next time you hear that, you want to make sure you stand up very straight and tall and make a loud prairie dog barking sound, like, because prairie dogs have to warn each other if there's danger. Remember to be super loud so all your friends can make it back to their burrow. Good job.
Citizen Science.
We have a great citizen science project for you today that you can do from just about anywhere. It's called Project Squirrel. All you have to do is look out your window or go outside and count how many squirrels you see. This is a squirrel I saw outside my window, climbing in a maple tree and getting some maple seeds to eat. But it's okay if you don't see any squirrels at all. Scientists want to know places that we're not finding squirrels, too. Then just use a phone, tablet, or computer to go to projectsquirrel.org and fill out the survey about what you saw. It just asks you a few simple questions about how many squirrels you saw and what kind they were. The Project Squirrel site even tells you how to tell the difference between a gray squirrel and a fox squirrel.
Now that I know so much about how animals move their bodies, I have some great ideas for my next living room dance party. Can you move your body like an animal? Can you hop like a frog? Can you slither like a snake? Can you dance like me?